Hi everyone, today I'm back in the Kia Garage Jacquet Automobile in Thonon-les-Bains in France, and I am here to test for you the crossover Kia Exceed plug-in hybrid. And this one has the options, you know, the design package, which brings you those nice 18 inches wheels. So the price of this car is around 38,490 euros, and it has a lot of, you know, options with this lineup. Now, in terms of numbers, so you have an electric motor of 60.5 horsepower. You have a battery capacity of 8.9 kilowatt hour and a charging system, you know, capacity maxed at 3.3 kilowatt, which will allow you to charge your car in 4 hours and 20 minutes on a, you know, home socket, or in 3 hours with a industrial, you know, public charger. In terms of maximum speed with the electric motor, you're gonna have a maximum speed of 120 kilometers per hour, and after that you're gonna have the ICE, the internal combustion engine, which will turn on. In terms of range of this car, it is for the WLTP system, it's around 59 kilometers, you know, driving in the city, and when you drive outside the city, it's around 48 kilometers, which are quite good numbers actually for such a, you know, battery capacity. Now, for the internal combustion engine, it is a 1.6 liter, four cylinders of 105 horsepower. You've got a gasoline, reservoir of 37 liters, and this car is a front-wheel drive. Now, in terms of maximum horsepower, it's around 141 horsepower with 265 newton meters pound feet of torque, which is not that bad actually. But unfortunately, the 0 to 100 is in 11 seconds. This car weighs 1.5 tons, you know, which is a lot. It's 160 kilos more than the 100% fuel version of this car. But at least you will pollute less with this one, and maybe have some better, you know, financial advantages because it pollutes less. So this is not that bad. Now, in terms of design of this car is, I think that the design is very good of this car. It is well finished. There is nothing to say. It has a little, you know, dynamic style, which is, very nice. You've got full LED lights in the front and in the back, which is also very good. And for this specific one, you're gonna have, for the plug-in hybrid, this nice design here. So, you know, a full one here. And you're gonna have also the, the charging port here, which has a Type 2 socket, to charge the car. Now, in terms of trunk, now let's go see the trunk of this car. Ah, and also we've got here those two fake exhausts with, adds, some elegance and some style in the car. So actually, the design is very good. There is nothing bad to say about it. It's great. Now, in terms of trunk capacity, the normal one, so the completely, fuel engine one, has a capacity of 426 liters, and this one has only 291, because you're gonna have the battery here in the back, and also, you know, beneath the seats, which will take some space, unfortunately. Then here you have, the space to put your cables, and if I can show you, maybe in the back you can see the batteries, a part of the batteries right here. You're gonna have here something, to put some stuff in, and to have this, charging port right here if you ever need to put something. And now, if you would like to have some more space, you can take down the rear seats, and I'm going to do that for you so you can have the maximum trunk space of it. I think it's 1,243 liters if you bring everything down. So I'm gonna try to do this for you. right here. And also like this. And I'm gonna try to take down the cover so you can have an appreciation of the space. So with one hand, it's unfortunately not that easy. Whoops. And there you go in terms of full space in the back. Now, I'm going to put this like this. There you go. Now I would like to show you the space that you have in the back and the different materials that you have. So, in terms of materials, you're gonna have here some hard plastic, not real leather, and hard plastic again. Here you're gonna have also, you know, the fake leather, you're gonna have some tissue here, which is also very comfortable. And the front seats are adjusted for my height, which is, you know, 182 centimeters. And now let's see for the space. So in terms of leg space for my height, well, you know, it's enough. It's quite good. I can move my leg freely here and also like this. So nothing to say, but if you are like, you know, 190 centimeters, you might be a little too big for the rear seats, but you are very well seated. There you can control the, you know, the strength of the air blow if you would like. And unfortunately, we can see that we are missing some USB charging port. So, well, you know, that's sad. It's not, you know, a must, but well, it's like that. But otherwise, the seats are very nice and are comfortable when this is enough for me. Now, let's go see the front part of the car. So, sound door check. Very good. And same in the front. Nice noise, which is very great. So now we're gonna have, you know, the same thing that behind, but here we're gonna have a soft plastic, which is different than in the back. Here we have some fake leather and some hard plastic. Here again, fake leather and tissue here with the same motifs, you know, design than behind. And you have here, you know, to have a better, you know, grip on the seats, which is very great. And you can, you know, well, move the seats manually up and down here. And you have, you know, for the lumbar support that you can control here. Now, something very nice that I would like to show you on this car in the front, you're gonna have is here the, you know, a soft plastic, but it has a design like if it was, you know, leather. So this I would like to point out because it adds, you know, elegance for this car. Now, in terms of interior, the car is, you know, very simple, nothing, you know, too shiny, too shabby. It's very nice. And you're gonna have here a 10.25 inch screen and here a 12.3 inches screen. Now let's talk about the buttons. Here you're gonna have, you know, the usual stuff, nothing special, you know, for the to control the windows here, the things here, and you're gonna have here some other buttons to, you know, to adjust the height of the lights, the intensity of the light of, you know, the inside clusters. Here to activate or deactivate the lane assist, active lane assist, the ESP, the gasoline thing. And if you would like also to, you know, if you have, for example, configured special hours to charge the car, but you don't want them to be active, you can just turn it off here. Gonna have the little, you know, shifters here. Gonna have to control the lights and also the wipers. With the wipers with the auto mode, which has, you know, the intensity that you can change. And here you're going to have all that is related to the infotainment system, so, you know, for the vocal commands to switch between sources, to change between, you know, channels, and to change the sound, and to you know, the volume, and to, you know, answer or not some phone calls. And here you can have some buttons here to control, which, you know, the menus that you have in front of you here that we're gonna see after, and also to control, you know, the speed limiter, the adaptive cruise control, and, you know, to have some other stuff being shown up that I'm gonna show you after. Here we're going to have, you know, the usual buttons, you know, to close the car for the warnings, if you have the passenger and airbag on or off. And you have the instruments here, you know, to control the ventilation with a little display here and here that we're going to see after. You can also have the driver only, blowing, you know, only on you, which will allow you, you know, not to, to heat up or to cool down the car, you know, the entire car, and you're the only one here. Then here you can a little space to charge your phone, wireless charging that you can turn on or completely off if you want through the menu of this screen here. You have some space to, well, you have a charging port here. You have a USB port here for the charging your phone and also to make the Apple CarPlay and Android Auto work. And you have here another USB port, but this is just, you know, to charge your phone. Here you have the thing, the usual thing, which is also quite nice. You have different buttons here. We can have the full 100% EV mode, but there is a little twist about it that I would like to talk to you about. You can switch also to the auto mode, which allows the car to switch between the EV mode, the electric engine or the ICE, depending, you know, on the load that you're asking of the car. You know, if you're, for example, pressing the accelerator pedal too fast or too strong, it will activate the ICE. And if you if you put the heat too strong, for example, it will also turn on the ICE. And you can have a hybrid mode, so the car will behave like a normal hybrid vehicle, which is also, you know, quite nice. So the car will switch more often between both engines. You can hear the parking sensors, which is in the front, in the back, and you also have the camera that I will show you after, the automatic parking system. You have here the possibility, you know, for the electric or electronic handbrake and the auto hold feature. For this feature, it will reset itself after each, you know, start of the car. So if you'd like to have this function always on, you have to, you know, to press it every time you start the car. You can have, you know, some space to put your bottles. Here it goes, here it does not, so the sizes are not the same. And you can also make it more discreet like that and put some stuff here like your keys or, you know, some money. And here you have a little space also to put your stuff inside, which is quite deep, which is also very nice. Now let's see the what this menu here, this little screen, has to offer us. So let's put our car in, you know, in accessory mode. And so here you have everything that is related to the speed, to your fuel tank, you know, your tank, your fuel remaining. Here the power that you're going to ask the car and if you're on or off. I will show you after when we start the car. And here you have, you know, the range of the car and the level of the battery. Now let's switch with here. With this one, let's change menus. So here you can have the speed displayed in, you know, numeric values, and by pressing up and down you can have, you know, some driving style, energy flow, engine temperature, fuel economy, accumulated info, and drive information. If you press it on it again, you have here the compass. And if you have an address, you know, if you're using the GPS, it will also show you some directions. You will not have a full map, but some directions. And here more about, you know, the I think that here can show you that if it sees the lanes, for example, and the car in front of you. And you can have the attention level and the tire pressure if the car is on, and the tire pressure is of course individual to each wheels, which is also very nice. I have forgotten to talk to you about one mode. I'm just realizing. Here you can see the eco mode on the left. So this is actually the normal mode of the car. You can switch it here with the sport mode, and the car will be the display will change, and you will see now it's sport on the left, and the car will go, as you can see here, in HEV mode. So with the sport mode, is only available with the HEV mode. This is something, you know, just to note. I think this is it for this screen. Now let's go to this one. So this is a very nice screen, which is, you know, very very reactive, you know, very dynamic. This is just great. Here I have some widgets that you can change by pressing menu, edit home widgets, and you can put another one or replace it because there's only, you know, three available. Maximum, you have the weather, the driving info, the clock, if you would like, you know, to change. Now we have here, if you click on here, you will have some statistics like the EV range, the battery remaining, if you have, you know, some charge management with, you know, some times, eco driving, so some statistics about, you know, average fuel engine use, electric motor use, and some history, which is also very nice to have. And we have the energy flow, which is here more detailed than you know, on the other screen. And you can see how, you know, the energy flow, what is working, how is it regenerating, etc. The car can regenerate when you take your foot off the pedal, of the accelerator pedal, and when you start braking. Now, what is interesting also, we're gonna have, well, here the GPS. I don't want to go somewhere, I just want to show you that, you know, the menu is just great. I think that, can we do this also? Yeah. And, you know, so it's good. The screen is very good. Nice feeling when you touch, and it's also very, you know, reactive. What more, you have here some other menus, like, you know, the map, navigation, phone, Kia Live, the PHEV menu we have seen before, and some driving info, settings, favorite, etc. In the settings, you're gonna have, which is here the button for the setup, actually, you're gonna have more possibilities with the vehicle, like, for example, the warning timing, the driver orientation warning for safety, lane assist, etc., etc. Some options for the climate, eco vehicle, like the coasting guidance. I have never seen it, you know, working yet, because I think I've never been coasting. I don't know. I never, you know, realized that when I was driving. And you have, you know, all the auto lock feature, auto unlock, etc., etc. What do we have also interesting? So we have the FM radio, the DAB radio, Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, and I think that's it. So we don't have any CDs in this car. And here we have, you know, some shortcuts that you can have. Map, navigation, favorites that I think can be, that you can configure them in the menu. For the seek, the truck, radio, switch between media, and the advanced setups that you can have here of the car. It's actually very great. I do like the screen and how it's working. Now, also that I have it, put it, turn it on, you have the auto feature and the sync. I think now, just to finish, there is something important I would like to tell you about this car. Maybe some of you have noticed it, you know, while driving. When you turn on the car, it starts in full, complete EV mode. But some of you may have noticed that suddenly, for no reason, when you just started the car, you have the thermal engine, which you know, which turns on, and there is actually a very good reason for that. We have a very small electric motor of 60 horsepower. For your own safety, when you have, for example, you know, to take over someone or to, you know, accelerate quite fast, the 60 horsepower is not enough. It has to give you the 141 horsepower. So the engine will turn on. But if it turns on without having, you know, some oil in the engine first, it's not very good for the life, you know, expectancy of the engine. So this is quite good. So you turn the car, it's fully EV mode, the car will, you know, get some oil, it will turn on, and then after this if you need some power, it will already be, you know, lubed up before, you know, before having, you know, to kick in too aggressively for its own good, which is very good. Also, with this kind of cars, with, you know, plug-in hybrids, sometimes the fuel engine can maybe not turn on for months, and it's good for the car to have a little bit of oil inside from time to time, you know, for the corrosion effect, so you don't have, you know, you have less rust problems over the time. So this is also a very good stuff, a good thing. Here you have the little thing here, which can control the how do you say already, you know, if someone blinds you, it can put it, you know, I think less bright. You have here to put your sunglasses if you have. You can control the lights and also the roof panel. And it has also, you see, the blindfold, which is automatic, and this is very, very nice. I do like it. So it's very cool. So I will take this again. So this is well, you know, well thought. Okay, I think that's it for the interior and exterior review of the car. Now I would like to make a little drive with you, maybe just to show you the different modes of driving, if I can. See you soon. Okay, so now let's make a little test drive with the car. So I'm showing you here the the energy flow of the car, and we are going to see with the different modes. So I'm going to start with the EV mode just to show you. So now we're in full electric mode. What is great is that the car is, you know, well soundproofed, let's say. You know, you don't have too much noise from outside, and also, you know, of the engine, of course, but with the electric engine you will not hear anything special. But the car is well, you know, isolated. This is a very good point. The suspensions can be a little bit, you know, stiff sometimes, but otherwise they're also very comfortable, nothing to say. And for the steering wheel system, you know, the assist and everything, also it's some could say it's a little bit, you know, heavy, but I find myself that this is very comfortable. So now let's see, we are at 80, now let's go to 90, and you can see the car is still in full EV mode. Okay, so the car can handle at least 90 full EV mode. Now, if I go to the power zone of the car, if I go a little bit too much, the car will engage for your own safety, so you can also have, you know, more power to take over another car. It will engage the thermal engine, and when you have finished, it will go back, you know, to the full EV mode. So this is how it works. And also I take my foot off the accelerator pedal, or if I brake, it will charge the car. Now, if you put also the heat too strong, so let's put the heat here, you're gonna have the thermal engine also, which, you know, which goes off. So it turns on. Okay, so this is something good to keep in mind, so you don't take too much of your, you know, battery just to heat the car. Now we have also the auto mode. Now let's turn off this. The auto mode, it's the same principle here. If I go a little bit too strong, it will engage the electric engine, and if I put the heat too strong, it will also engage. Now I do not really feel the difference between the full EV mode and the auto mode. Maybe there are some other criterias which will decide which engine the car should use depending on which condition. Now I do not see the real difference between those two with the driving that I have made with the car. So maybe you have the answer if you know this car very well. On my side, I do not see really the difference. Now we have two other mode to test, and we are going to to go back. And I also have forgot to show you something. I think when you put the rear gear, you're gonna have the camera screen, which is very good for the quality. And I think I forgot to show you that. So let's go back. I have the directional line and the fixed lines. So this is great with the quality of the camera, which is really, really great. And now we are going to go into the D mode and to the let's start with the sport mode, which brings your car directly, automatically to the hybrid mode. So you have very fast the complete power of the car. You have also a change in the design, of the clusters. And now let's go sport mode. Let's see what this car has to offer. Okay, so the car is a little bit more reactive. It has a dual clutch gearbox, which is extremely comfortable in every situation, in EV mode, in auto mode, HEV mode. The clutch system is comfortable. There is nothing bad to say about it, except that sometimes you may consider it as a bit slow, to change gear. I don't know what, it's maybe not that reactive, but otherwise it's a good one. It's a good gear system. Now let's go to the standard HEV mode. Okay, and now for the HEV mode, the car is going to be more sensitive to engage the ICE. As you can see, I'm not really pressing hard, and the car decides, okay, now I'm going to turn the engine on. So it's like a, as I said maybe already, it's like having a normal hybrid but with a very big battery. So this is very nice. I like the HEV mode. I really enjoy it because you have a car that is, more reactive, because you always have available in any time those 141 horsepower. I think that if I go a bit much to the left, just to show you for the lane assist, you can see here it blinks and it drives automatically, to keep me in lane. If I if I put everything in automatic, and if I take my hands off after a certain time, it will tell me, please put the hands back on the wheel, on the steering wheel. So it's a pressure system. It's not because you do it like this, it's because it has to feel that you handle the car. That's why, it will give you a warning if you are not, giving some pressure from time to time, if you engage, all the automatic driving modes. So I guess for this review of the car, this is over for me. I think that this car is very great. It's very comfortable. It has a very nice design. The only bad spot for this car is maybe the trunk space and the gear system, which can be a little bit slow. Otherwise, suspensions, seats, design, elegance, and the hybrid system, I think that they are very, very great. You should at least try this car yourself to make your own opinion. But for me, it's a very nice car. Very nice car. So I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe, or leave me a comment, and I will see you next time for another review. Bye bye.